What up, what up, what up, what up? It's your boy E.T. Look, do me a huge favor, guys. Finish strong. Are you hearing me? Finish strong. Rule number one, don't get comfortable. Rule number one, don't get comfortable, right? We have 30 days left in this year, right? And so I don't need you to do something big every day, but I do need you to do something small in those 30 days. Plant some small seeds at least. So boom, next year this time, you can look up and say, ah, I've made the rest of my life the best of my life. So it's your boy E.T. I'm telling you and yours to enjoy these holiday seasons and make sure you make the rest of your life the best of your life. He told the guy, he said, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. So I want to be honest with you guys. Let me just say this, because maybe like you're so in it, you don't know. But from a cultural, I think I was talking to Ken the other day, and I just want to be transparent. We were talking about the American dream, right? And Ken said, what sport did you tell me is the American sport? I said, it's not, but it's golf. Everybody playing baseball, right? There's an elite group of people playing golf, right? Golf is not a sport, it's also a what? It's a culture. It's not just a hobby, it's a culture.
Eric Thomas.
Chris, nice to meet you.
Eric Thomas.
Mike, nice to meet you.
So we're gonna spend some time together, hopefully. I know I can't help you with your game, but hopefully I can help you with your game, though.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I can't get you out there and do, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I might not even be able to hit the ball. I've never tried, you know? So I can't help you with that, but hopefully help you with some mental strategies that can take you to another level.
And I want you to believe in what you believe in. Like wholeheartedly. I'm gonna say it again, sound real simple. I want you to believe in what you believe in, wholehearted. I want you to put all the chips down, nothing in reserve. Now, this is why this is important, because psychologically, whether you know it or not, if you 80-20, it's gonna affect your game. You 80-20, you 80% you believe, you got, I don't know if I'm doing that right or not, I don't know, but 80-20, you got 20%, and we know that more than any other game in the world. Golf is a what kind of game? It's a mental game.
So I'm from Kernersville, North Carolina. I grew up in Virginia, moved to Kernersville when I was 12. Fell in love with the game when I was really young. My dad and brother really inspired me a lot, and now I'm 21, so it's about 10 years of being pretty competitive in the game. What I've learned so much about EU, and I've realized that it just applies to every area of your life, not only golf, but it's the small things. It's just the small things. Not like I changed much physically, but I changed my routine. It's like E says, you just gotta get to the spot. And if you get there, it's crazy how things can change. And so it just really being deliberate in the small things has definitely changed my game dramatically.
I have a routine every morning. I wake up at the exact same time, 3 o'clock in the morning, a little bit before that, first hour in prayer. And I'm not being spiritual. I'm just telling you what my routine is. I'm working on my mind. There's certain things I read every morning. There's certain people I connect with that are also 120. Like I don't connect with the 80-20s. If you 80-20, I'll start talking to you after one.
This is my first time ever hearing him talk. So I thought it was a great experience for me. I came in with an open mind. It's really interesting. The main thing that stuck with me was how he spoke about his routine in the morning and how he doesn't let anyone who's not 100% talk to him before 1 o'clock. So I think it's a great idea to sometimes keep them out of the way and keep the negativity out until you're at a stage where you can block that out yourself, where you've woken up enough and got yourself prepared for the day.
I beat anybody on the planet. Why? Because you're working out of talent and talent only. I'm working out of maybe 60, 70% talent. And then the rest is all mental. People say, come on, E, you're one of the best. No, I'm one of the most consistent.
Some of my kids have been listening to your stuff for a minute, which is crazy because I didn't know.
Right.
One of my best players, he's been listening to your stuff for 5 years. He ain't been like 20.
Well, I've played golf all my life. It's something that I always wanted to do. I actually want to turn pro as soon as I graduate. I don't know, I've been seeing him now for 5 years. It was pretty amazing seeing him.
And it's just unreal what he said, how it just makes you really think about all this stuff that, I don't know, he wants to make you really think about some sort of things that, and aspects that you don't really like focus on. He made some really good points about mental toughness. That's something that you really need on the golf course.
I'm not smart, I'm not intelligent, I don't have no support, but I have mental toughness. This is why mental toughness is important. This is why focus is important. Listen to me. Where your focus goes, your energy flows. Let's be honest. You thought maybe you could eagle. I don't know. You thought you could birdie, at least par. Like, you thought you could, and then you end up bogeying. Like, what happens to you mentally? You turn that one. Let's say it happened on the second hole, right? You turn that into the third, the fourth, and fifth. It just happened in one. And we know that you can still win, and you can have a bad hole and still win. So why do we lose? Because you turn one bad hole into 10 bad holes mentally. You messed up one time, and in your mind, like, oh, this is a habit. This is a pattern. This is going to happen the next one. And because you said in your mind, subconsciously said in your mind, man, I messed up. You didn't say, I'm going to live in the present. That's over with. Here go the next one. I'm living the present. Like, there go that one. I'm going with the third, the fourth. I don't care what happens in the third or fourth. We're going to play each one. You actually turn the next one into the last one. And this is why mental toughness is so important. We do it with negative more than positive. It would be one thing if we were as strong. You might have something happen to you positively, and you're not like, all right, the next five is positive. We only really do it with the negative. We give the negative a lot of energy. We don't get a positive as much energy.
Play on the PGA Tour. What E has helped me realize is I got to put that everywhere. So now it's the background of my phone. It's on my desk everywhere. I have those four major championship trophies because that's the ultimate goal. And to become the best player in the world. And so it's doing the small things that will allow me to do that, not just focus on that big picture goal.
All the greats, routine. What's your routine? And when you get your routine, it's going to be that much easier for you to stay mentally strong. You got to be ready for this stuff, guys. Don't you can ask anybody that's doing what you've done, who's done it before you, that it's only so many problems you're going to have as a professional golfer. It's only so many problems you're going to have. You need to find out what those problems are, and you need to start practicing for them now.
I think it's God working through him that just changed my life and changed my brother's life. And the fact that my parents got to meet somebody who literally changed my life, that meant so much to me, and I think it meant so much to E as well, just to get to meet my parents and just get to meet the whole family and my sister. It was very, meant a lot, a whole lot, that somebody who is so famous would take the time out of their day to talk and spend time and have a meal with someone who, no one really knows. But yet, E just invests that time with those type of people, which is why, he is who he says he is.